Ngayon, may pagsisimula na ang pag-alay ng 30 bulanan sa rebuto ng ating pambansang bayani na si Dr. Jose Rotacio Rizal Mercado E. Alonso Reyalon. Ang mga pagpon ay gagalitin ng Master Sergeant Johnny Delgado, Assistant Defense Attaché at PCMS Romeo Batuta Jr., Officer in Charge, Office of the Police Attaché. Ang unang palupon ay ihahandog ng Maria Agnes Cervantes, Jarche de Fer, Ginoong Dapag Pagkaporo, Vice Consul, at Colonel Lucredo Manalang Junior, Defense Attaché. Ang susunod na panupon ay ihahandog ni Dr. Brad Luzon, Consul General at Honore ng Pilipinas sa Karachi. Sa pagkakataon nito, kami po ay aming inihingan at ituruan din ang atensyon sa kanyang bahagi ng ating bulwaga upang pakinggan ang mga mensahe ng ating mga presidente Rodrigo Roa Duterte at susundan ang ating kalihim ng lagnay paglabas dito ang Pilor Lopsi para sa ating atensyon ngayon.
I acknowledge the Filipino, both here and abroad, as we celebrate the 100th anniversary of the transformation of the Filipino industry. This occasion is a testament to how our commanders fought for the freedom that we enjoy. They inspire us to take, after the courage of our heroes, that the target has used our ability, skills, and knowledge to the benefit of the world. Take by all the humanity learning in the past, especially in the countless hardships that we have endured in the future. Let our victories be remembered to the slave and love to the country and to the great act of victory for all our children. Let us also work together so that we can realize our vision for the world of families and those in the best of the community. We have a meaningful community. Mabuhay ang Pilipino. Mabuhay ang Pilipino.
The past 2 years have seen us weathering the worst of the pandemic. There was a challenge of staying productive and hopeful, of running not before God, and sustaining relationships and preserving economies amidst health and travel restrictions that became commonplace. While the pandemic is still very much with us, we have managed to get out of the marching arms of the storm, but not into its eye or more to come. We have survived this far, and with continued caution and vigilance, we are getting out of this altogether, create a yet better future. This 15th Independence Day, Filipinos all over the world are called to rise to the challenge of a new tomorrow. If there is anything that pandemic taught us, it is to never underestimate humankind's capacity to evolve and adapt. We have seen this in ourselves, our families, and communities. We, in the Department of Foreign Affairs, did not let the pandemic stop us from cultivating foreign partnerships, securing much needed vaccines, upholding our sovereign rights, getting overseas Filipinos out of distress, and sharply increasing already considerable consular services. We rose to the occasion, even as our compatriots abroad and nations served on the front lines while supporting their families in the Philippines. Overseas Filipinos will always be a source of pride and inspiration. They are the subjects of royal honors, the gratitude of the admiration of foreign nations. The DNA is privileged for the opportunity. It has gripped with both hands to be beside you in a perilous journey, never leave you behind. Our endeavors, our struggles, and more food, just in time for our country to exercise democracy through free and fair elections with no restrictions other than those common sense self-imposes. The sovereign will of the Filipino people through free, fair, unrestricted elections, an expansion of our national independence found its fullest expression than the views of clear and incontestable will. I was proud to announce this to the American President and the U.S. Congress. This enables us to set the vision that we need tomorrow, we will all be working for. Thank you, President Rodrigo Duterte, for making it happen. The only president in our history to end his term with nationwide 70% approval and 0% approval in resolving besides standing down. This good man was vilified by so-called democracies that are racist, divided, unable to produce majorities, and are at best confused about friends. As we now begin a new chapter in our nation's history, I offer my very best wishes and profound appreciation to my colleagues in the Department of Foreign Affairs. It has been an honor to serve our country and people by your side. But there is so much to do, and still so many challenges to overcome. But my faith in the DNA, let my faith in the Philippines, strong and unbreakable. With this, I greet you from outside as Secretary of Foreign Affairs. May God Aranda, Kasarindan, Mapumari and Pilipinas, at Aung San Bayan, Pilipinas.
And forget that those who have fallen during the night. In these important words of our national hero, we remember that the gift of independence which went to us by our forefathers was brought to the inexorable sacrifice and a dragging over the future of the country. As we look back at the road that led us to the freedom and democracy we enjoy today, we also set our sights on the work that remains to be done to achieve the brighter future of our heroes. This year's Independence Day celebration of Kalayaan Kami Kami Tu, Pagsuo sa Kama ng Panibagong Bukas, or Rise Towards the Challenge of the New Beginning, aptly calls on confidence to embrace the changes coming our way. In this period of transition, may we continue to work together with our new set of leaders to realize the hopes and dreams of our forefathers of our nation. Magbigaya ng araw ng mga sabihan sa mga ito, the chief and the sana, secretary, department of national affairs.
Maraming salamat, Pernambuco. Pagkakao, Pernambuco,
Gracias. nakikita ng ganito, Presidente ko, ay pinapaypayan ako. Baliktad ang hawak ko. Baliktad ang hawak ko. Ito na lang. Kung ang plug ko, nakikita ba? Tapos na. Napicture na ng plug mo.
Galing
ganyan.
Yung photo na gagawin sa
Thank you.
Pilipino community po.
Ayan na.
Lahat po ay
ang grabe kinit.
Upang sama-sama kita pagkumain.
Uy, hindi kayo dyan. Hindi yan dyan sa inyo. Mga official yan dyan siguro. Mga ano na yan dyan. Naka-reserve yan, naka-reserve. Dito wala. Walang reservation. Sabay mo na lang din ako.
Ba't ba si Mira ilagin nyo? Wala.
Asa sa
inay.
Hoy, tanda nyo na.
Tingnan mo, doon sila umano. Matagal ako.
Kakain sila, kakain.